Pilsen neighborhood is Chicago's largest Latino community. One of the many murals and neighborhood buildings have expressed the history of struggles and social protest over the years. In the 1970s, a critical problem of quality education in the community was focused on Froebel High. 70% of the students there had dropped out by 1973 because the conditions were intolerable. Parents and students participated in a march to demonstrate their vital need for a new school. As a result, in 1977, a new school was built called Benito Juarez High School. Doors opened in 1978 and a new mural was commissioned to celebrate this triumph of the Pilsen community. This is the story of that mural.
There were four people in a competition with three designs. Salvador Vega's design, Malú's, and Jaime's design, which were working in conjunction. Actually, Malú was the one that came up with the colors. And Jaime put the line, and my design. And the way it was judged is that they put several people from the community and a few teachers, I think, if I'm not correct. I think there were three from Benito Juarez High School. Okay, but the art program director, there's a group from a community which it's represented by a guy named Valadez, and he's like a president from a group from a community, and several, you must say, directors from the community, like Pilsen neighbors, which and about 8 or 9 housewives.
Now we, as a committee, we asked for this contest, and they all prepared something. Everybody had a mural all prepared, and they showed it all to us, the mural committee. We called the council, the rest of the Benito Juarez Advisory Council. We called them together and asked and told them, so these are the entries. We can all look at them, and we decide which one we want. Each one of the artists explained their work, and then we retired and went to another room. And we all decided then, and it was by vote, and they all picked the one by Jaime Longoria and Malú Ortega.
El motivo de que yo voté por el mural es el conjunto con todas las ideas de mis compañeros, es lo mismo. El dibujo es algo diferente a lo que ya tenemos. Hay muchos murales por todo el barrio, pero siempre representan el mismo, ¿cómo podría explicarme? Lo mismo, ¿verdad? ¿Cómo puede decir? Lucha. La lucha y las mismas fotografías de Dolores y todo eso, ¿verdad? La esclavitud y todo. Y esto se nos figuró que es algo para nosotros moderno, un poco más moderno.
Well, personally, when I paint a mural, I try to be as realistic as possible. Try to give a message, right? But on this wall, I like it because it's different, because we're painting it. I never painted a mural the way we're painting this particular wall. And like I say, it's a lot of people disagree with the wall, and it's obvious because they are used to seeing murals painted in a strictly Chicano sort of thing, you know. And as time goes by and times changes, so does the artist. The artist has to expose himself to change. Otherwise, there is no point in being an artist if you don't change.
Can we get some of that blue in there? Kind of real strong, real light, delicate streaks like Maestro is using over here. That's real electric. And except, you know, without the white jazz. You know, like you did at the other end, you put in that yellow. You invented that yellow in there, which brought it out. That might be nice to have this kind of come out, because when I snare it with the black lines, then it becomes real active. And I need a lot of force on this figure here. So if we can get that. By and large, guys are so good that, you know, you just tell them, this is what I'd like to see. And then they do something, and oftentimes it's more than I expected. And it's just incredible stuff that we're doing here.
My name is Malú Ortega y Alberro. This is the first time I paint a mural. And the idea came when we knew we were going to have a competition, a Casa Aztlán, and Jaime Longoria and myself decided to work together. And I have always felt that my strongest part in terms of as an artist is the color. And we decided that we were going to use my colors.
I think that the mural, the way Jaime and Malú explained it, tells a lot about the youth. And I have heard, you know, some good things about it. Although, it still needs to be explained, because I was there, it was explained to me, and there are students who have also asked, well, why did you choose that mural? What does it say? I think murals is something that needs to be explained, that I know what it means when I look at the whole mural. I told my son what it means, although for him it's a little harder to understand because I can't make a very clear presentation like the artist did.
The last 10, 15 years, Chicanos, Latinos have been using murals to communicate messages. At the same time that they were doing it, they were expressing aesthetic concerns. Now, when I came along to approach this wall, I thought, well, isn't it about time that we took all the aesthetic concerns that have been manifested in all those works and just put them into one work? And this figure here being that of a gangbanger, monster, which can also work as a police killer, is done in that style. The lines are produced often for their own beauty, for their own excitement, for their own joy. These two figures are gangbangers. And the reason I depicted them the way they are is that the one on the left is skeletal. Again, the left being that part which could think. But because it's not thinking, not really working, it's dead. And on the right, we have the passion. And it's my observation of gang structure that the brains of the outfit usually gets the passionate outfit in trouble and gets them killed. So that this group is the one that's responsible for the eventual death. And in combination with the monster down at the end, who actually commits the act of violence, you know, they destroy our community. The biggest enemy that we have at this time in this community is not any white oppressor, not any outside force. It is the gang youth who are failing their responsibility to become warriors for our people. And when I talk about warriors, I'm talking about political warriors, I'm talking about economic warriors, people who are willing to go out there and make the necessary sacrifices against their own interest for the betterment of the whole. And that means sitting down and working.
What happened here?
Well, somebody came over and threw some paint on this wall and are calling up for a meeting to discuss and create another wall. In other words, somebody that are boycotting this wall, they don't like the content. They expect another artist to paint about the history of the Mexican people. Now, this wall in itself, it has a political statement, you know. Yes, it isn't finished. This is not the first wall that is done, in terms of a political mural, this is not the first wall that is done in this way.
Proposal. We want a mural that we can understand, one more simple and clear, something that our community and others can understand and feel, one that has to do with our sufferings toward the school and our ancestors. Like Benito Juarez, with the participation of the students themselves, the student of our community, the student of Benito Juarez High School. We want a muralist of our community, like Marcos Raya, Aurelio Diaz, or Salvador Vega. Not someone who doesn't belong here and who doesn't know what we went through to get to school. We don't want Jaime Longoria because he doesn't belong here. We would like some changes in our community. We want a history, not a mentally high, rich, not understandable mural. Our proposal is made because we would like a new mural at Benito Juarez High School. We would like the artists mentioned before to present their projects that they have for Benito Juarez so the students and parents could judge, not only teachers. We want a general meeting in Zapata Park so students and parents could attend in the judging process. We want our radio stations to know about this, television, newspapers, and magazines. Also March, Gatzeslan, and St. Procopius. We will see you all there. This petition and proposal was made by our students and the community of Pilsen neighbors to stop the mural that is in process at Benito Juarez. See you all at the meeting, Zapata Park.
This is not a traditional thing. This is something that is something new and something that represents what the new generations are thinking of. It's not what the rest of the community thinks of or wants, but what they, the kids, want.
Can you tell us a little bit about what you think this mural means to you as a student in this community?
Being a black American in this neighborhood for the last maybe 16, 17 years, I feel that it explains a lot of the struggles and the stress that the Mexican American people went through.
Why do you think they put this mural on the wall of a high school?
Well, in a way, because it's mostly a Latin school, and it kind of explains what type of struggle the Mexican people had to go through as surviving in America, plus in their own land. I guess they feel that the same struggle is still going on. I mean, it's still the struggle for education, a struggle for the strive of a better man. As I noticed, they have a lot of different working people too, like the man with the hammer, which explains the workers' union, different thing which a lot of the Mexican people strive for, because they are a lot of the farmers of the land and the workers.
Well, the more people working at new ideas, the better everybody can be, better off anybody can be. Right.
I think it shows that the Latinos have a great advantage, that they're not what every people think they are. They have the freedom to learn, to further their education, because it's something that nobody can take away from them. And they can make something big of themselves, not just in the street like everybody says they are. There's somebody. The mural, it shows the student to further his education in order to become somebody. It's up to him in order to do, you know, to be somebody.
A small man called his name in the air, and his echoes were lost in the dreams of his children. Through their eyes, a story, how this time we couldn't lose the struggle for a school or third hand clothes, the fight for a peace of mind, our pride back in our hands, the terror, a blink in a tiny sleep. And every day of their lives, they hear echoes in their mother's eyes, the tears that watch them grow from dim to heavy stroke colors on the walls for each child to see, the dreams awakened of long ago, and the small man who cries in the air.